All right, settle in. Go get a drink or maybe a blanket because today we are talking about PvP. PvP in Destiny 2 in 2021. Even though I'd probably rather talk about, wow, so many other things. The office, moving to Peacock, whatever the f*** that is, how much I hate winter, bean dad. But here we are about to talk about PvP for D2. If you're on Twitter, well, first of all, you should follow me, of course. But you may have noticed that lately a bunch of folks in the community have been dropping very opinionated thoughts about the current state of D2 PvP. Hottest man alive and lover of hamsters, Glad, weighing in that he feels very removed from the PvP side of D2 altogether, and PvP main Hush revealing that he's no longer happy with the current state of PvP, and is going to take a break to do other things. I know and love both these fellows, so it does hurt to hear their frustrations with PvP, but I have to be honest, I understand where they're coming from. I'm now going to briefly give you my thoughts on the current state of D2 PvP, as well as common frustrations that I've heard from other players and the vocal online community regarding PvP in Season 12. Let's start with the very obvious frustration, which is the introduction of Stasis. One of the upcoming videos I'm working on for next week, I think, is my first ever tier list for D2. Can't wait for all the arguments on that bad boy. A tier list for every subclass in PvP. Spoiler alert, all three Stasis subclasses are going to be ranked very highly. And don't get me wrong, it's not simply that the classes are just so strong to the point of overshadowing many other classes. They can also be frustrating to play against. Revenant, Behemoth, and Shadebinder all work very well together at cleaning house and at directly supporting one another in-game. For example, if you're a Revenant hunter and you somehow whiff your shatterdive glacier nade combo, you probably don't need to worry about it too much because if you have another Revenant or Behemoth on your team, and odds are you will, they can just feed you the nade that you need. A Revenant hunter, or any Stasis class really, can activate Whisper of Shards on any teammate's Glacier Nade to recharge their own. A Behemoth Titan can activate Tectonic Harvest on any teammate's Glacier Nade in addition to their own to refresh their melee timer. Other subclasses have their own methods of ability regen, sure, but no classes feed into one another quite as hard as the new Stasis ones. Revenant Hunter Shatterdive plus Glacier Nade plus Whisper of Fissures, aka the Hunter Dunk, is not only devastatingly lethal, but criminally easy to execute in-game. Combine that with the fact that it can one-shot, or at the very least, heavily damage enemies from multiple meters away, and on top of that, the fact that it is arguably better at shutting down roaming supers than even the Titan Suppression Grenade, all adds up to just a lot. But anyway, not to get too hung up on one particular ability, this video isn't gonna boil down to, well, just delete Whisper of Fissures and everyone is gonna be happy. Most people I've heard from are just frustrated with Stasis overall. A very big part of that is, in a game where movement and gunplay really do shine, it kinda sucks to have your movement hindered or even completely outright eliminated via getting slowed down or frozen by Stasis. No one likes getting completely immobilized, and because this is easily done via the neutral game with the three new subclasses, as you can imagine, there is a lot of slowing down and freezing going on in PvP right now. This is a huge task for Bungie. What do I mean by that? I can only imagine how much sweat and work hours went into creating a brand new class element and three brand new subclasses, which, as we can only imagine, are only going to be further expanded upon as we get deeper into year 4 and beyond. I'm sure a fair amount of PvP players would be really happy if Bungie were to just snap their fingers and, quote, remove Stasis subclasses from the game, end quote. But as you can probably imagine, that is not really a realistic approach for Bungie to take. Not only would that probably be erasing thousands of hours of work on their end, it would completely throw a wrench into upcoming content as well. At least I'm guessing it would. Stasis itself has also been woven into the fabric and story of the game pretty hard. It's essentially a bell that cannot be unrung. So now what Bungie has is the very daunting task of both balancing Stasis in PvP and making it so that it isn't as frustrating to play against for the majority of the player base. On a personal note, I'm not exactly thrilled about getting frozen in PvP. I do find it very annoying. But again, personal note, it's not really what's weighing heavily on my fun factor. Do I think the new three subclasses need tuning? Yes. Do a lot of other subclasses probably feel like they're lagging pretty far behind in a world of ice? Big yes. But let's move on to other things that aren't ice related. Let's talk really quickly about weapons and the loot pool. As of the writing of today's video, two of the strongest weapons in the PvP sandbox are the True Prophecy hand cannon and the Fellwinter's Lies shotgun. Both of these weapons are currently unobtainable in the D2 loot pool. Now, before I begin my mini rant, I would like to clarify that Bungie has addressed that Fellwinter's Lie is going to be added to the exotic kiosk in the tower in Season 13, despite not being exotic. I'm definitely glad that Bungie is making the Fellwinter obtainable again in the next season, but I gotta make my feelings on this really clear. It's understandable that the obtainable loot pool at large is gonna change from time to time, but taking a meta-defining PvP weapon like Fellwinter's completely out of the loot pool at the height of its usefulness and at the beginning of a new year of the game is straight up harmful to the morale of new players and the PvP population at large. Imagine this, you're a new D2 player, or you're a vet player who got bogged down with, you know, life in 2020 and didn't get to play much, but you're finally stepping back into the game for Beyond Light. You wanna give PvP a whirl because, hey, it helps with pinnacle grinding, or there's a title you wanna go after, or maybe you just feel like playing. Now, it is expected that newer players or rusty players are gonna get kicked around in PvP for a bit as they learn or relearn the game, sure. But how do you think that new player is gonna feel when they learn that this insane top-tier weapon that they're repeatedly getting mollywopped by is 100% no longer obtainable in-game? They're gonna at the very least get discouraged, and at the absolute worst, they're gonna turn the game off and never turn it back on. Fallout, why bring this up if Bungie has already addressed that they're adding it back to the kiosk? Again, I'm very glad the weapon is being added to the kiosk for next season, but for a lot of players, the damage has been done. It's really important that we learn from this and avoid a repeat mistake where a meta-defining PvP weapon gets completely removed from the loot pool right when a ton of new and returning players are leaping back into D2. And look, I know, there's probably a select few of you out there who are of the mentality that, hey man, I earned this weapon fair and square. I played the quest, I did the whole thing, I earned it. If we just make strong weapons accessible all the time to everybody, it takes away from their specialness. I'm not saying that every player who gets Beyond Light should log in for the first time and have a shiny brand new Fellwinter sitting in their postmaster, but when the gun is as dominant in PvP as it is right now, having it be completely unobtainable is just soul-crushing to new and returning players, and the bottom line is that it directly translates to lower PvP population numbers. And with that, let's keep the momentum going and talk about sunsetting. I know, ultra surface of the sun, hot take time.
Better break out the suntan lotion.
I get what the goal of sunsetting is, but it's causing a lot of frustration. Here's something that shouldn't be a thing, in my opinion. I have a God Roll Astral Horizon shotgun. That's not what shouldn't be a thing. Please don't take that away from me. I have a God Roll Astral Horizon, got it a while back from Trials Grindin', which, by the way, kinda took a hefty amount of playtime due to RNG. That particular Astral I earned is set to get sunset at the end of Season 14 with a power cap of 1360. Fair enough. But with Trials back on the menu and the Astral Horizon still in the obtainable loot pool, any new Astral I get has a longer lifespan, i.e. the mediocre Adept one I picked up will now last until the end of Season 15 with a power cap of 1410. Sunsetting is supposed to retire certain weapons to make room for new, fresh weapons to keep the meta changing. So, Why am I being forced to regrind the same god rolls for weapons I already have? I know that, in theory, that particular aspect of sunsetting should be keeping players in PvP, because hey, party up guys, we gotta regrind a new god roll of a weapon we already have. But honestly, it just feels both exhausting and a little disrespectful of players' invested time. As a player, I want to feel like the juice I get is worth the squeeze. When I work really hard at squeezing that fresh astral juice out of the trials lemon tree, only to have Bungie turn around and say, hey, good job, now go grind another one exactly like it because we're taking that first one away. I feel like the time I spent grinding that first one has been somewhat wasted, or at the very least, not respected. If a weapon's sunsetting lifespan gets extended by a full season, or two, or longer, can we maybe have another way of taking our god rolls and having their lifespans extended to meet that updated sunset power cap? It doesn't have to be free. Maybe some kind of item, or reward, or trinket, or token, or currency, or whatever that a player can somehow earn, and then I can insert it into my old god roll astral, and presto changeo, its sunset power limit has now been updated to reflect newer versions of that exact same weapon. Just a thought. And because I briefly mentioned adept weapons, let's really quickly talk about that. In terms of the juice being worth the squeeze, I don't quite feel that adept weapons are where they need to be. Yeah, I know we're still early in that area. We've had 3 weeks of trials being back on the menu, 3 adept weapons total, and 3 adept weapon mods. I'm a fairly regular PvP player. When the Astral Horizon Shoddy was the adept weapon of the week, I decided to play trials on all 3 characters, something I rarely do anymore. Played a whole bunch, went flawless on each character, and got 3 adept shotguns. The RNG required to get the exact drop you want on any weapon in the game is still pretty brutal, but with the adept weapons, you feel it hard. None of my adept weapons so far, including my scout rifle and my summoner auto rifle, have dropped with rolls that I was happy about. If that is a bummer for me, I can only imagine that this is probably very devastating to a large number of players who rarely, if ever, manage to go flawless. I'm talking, of course, about our old friend Johnny Dayjob. Johnny Dayjob doesn't spend all day streaming. He's got a white-collar job that he doesn't like. He wants to come home and try to get dank loot in D2. He deals with a frustrating meta full of ice, bad connections. He's gotta hit up friends left and right to put a fire team together. He works to get his pinnacles so he can even enter trials. He struggles all weekend trying to go flawless, and when he does, he is rewarded with a terribly rolled adept weapon. At least the odds say that will be his reward. It's like the game just took a crap on his heart. I know a lot of people don't want to ever go back to the old days of D1 weapon reforging, but I think we should consider the possibility of changing adept weapons somehow. Maybe a curated role. Maybe if you play more trials, you can earn ways to change individual perks on your adept role. I don't know. Right now, the adept carrot on the end of the stick doesn't seem appealing enough to be chased by Johnny Dayjob each week. This kind of leads into my next topic. What are we currently chasing in PvP? What actual tangible rewards are sitting on the table for us, the player base, to earn in PvP in Beyond Light? The adored sniper rifle kind of comes to mind, cool pinnacle weapon, but you don't even need to step 1 foot into PvP to pick up that gun. Here's a good question to think about. Aside from earning powerfuls and pinnacles, what reason do you, or does anyone have, to step into the comp playlist right now? You could argue that players should only be stepping into comp to test their skill against other determined players and good teams. And while that isn't untrue, to me, it's also not enough. We gotta remember that at its core, Destiny is a looter shooter, and when there isn't enough loot to go after, that hurts the player base numbers. Other than getting a god-rolled Stars in Shadow, I can't really think of a ton of major in-game rewards awaiting Johnny Dayjob in regular PvP that absolutely can't be earned anywhere else in the game, excluding trials, of course. You can go into PvP for pinnacle drops, yeah, but if the average player is super frustrated and doesn't care that much about light level chasing anymore anyway, they're just gonna go for other pinnacles elsewhere and not deal with the trouble. We need more carrots to chase in PvP across the board. What we currently have to go after, in my opinion, simply is not enough. And as already mentioned, when there doesn't feel like a ton to begin with, and you finally get a drop with a bad roll, it hurts. When you work really hard at getting wins in trials, and you get a piece of trials armor to drop, and the stat roll is in the low 50s, it really does not feel good. If you're asking me, one of the overall goals for PvP in 2021 should be getting more players to routinely step into PvP for whatever reason. Ideally, they're also just stepping in to have fun, but that's a whole other kettle of fish. But yeah, more players in PvP. Give us more to go after, and we're at least halfway there. Give us routine vendor refreshes. Give us more options to customize our PvP earned drops. Give us more unique PvP earned emblems. Give more PvP focused titles. More unique PvP armor and weapons. Anything at all that revitalizes average Joe's interest in actually loading up PvP. And yeah, I know we're getting new legendary weapons in Season 13, two for Gambit, two for Strikes, and two for PvP. One of those weapons being the Palindrome, which I am looking forward to. But come on, man, that's not gonna hold player interest all on its own. Bungie brought back the frickin' Hawk Moon, and the player base numbers still aren't as strong as they need to be. Bringing back a beloved hand cannon on its own ain't gonna do much. We need more. Last two things I want to quickly talk about are the current maps and game types, as well as lobby balancing. Lobby balancing, despite being a very popular discussion topic in the PvP community, is insanely hard for me to break down, because getting firm data is damned difficult. It's easy for me to look at one game type as a whole, like trials, and say, well, here's our exact loot pool for that activity, and I know its effect, because I got all the data right here. Lobby balancing, though, would be a nightmare of a rabbit hole to dive down into. Yeah, you could get put into a game of quick play where your teammates don't exactly pop off, and you're top dog on the losing team, but there's a butt ton of factors that could be coming into play there. What if the folks on your team are trying out new weapons, or trying out new loadouts? What if they're trying to complete a PvP quest, or any other number of factors? But I'm not gonna pretend like this isn't an issue. Again, just really difficult to get hard data on it without knowing all outside factors. The problem here is that I would imagine Bungie is probably really tight-lipped about their secret matchmaking sauce. The more info they give us on how their matchmaking works, the more we, as a community, can scrutinize and criticize said matchmaking. The best we can do on this is speculation. All I would ask Bungie on this subject is that if there have been significant changes to how matchmaking is working with the release of Beyond Light, that they take in all the feedback regarding lobby balancing and make a decision that's in the best interest of the player base as a whole. All right, game types and map modes. Beyond Light brought with it zero new PvP maps. Minor oof. I'll admit, new PvP maps on their own aren't going to wave a magic wand and make the entire community thrilled to launch into PvP. But it does hint at a larger problem, the feeling that Bungie isn't tremendously focused at giving the PvP community the level of attention it might need at the moment. As I mentioned earlier, aside from players launching up PvP to chase a bunch of carrots, ideally, players are opening and diving into PvP to have fun. New game types and maps aren't the end-all be-all solution, but adding the right stuff could drastically improve the amount of fun folks are having in PvP. If my memory serves me correctly, Bungie may have mentioned in the past that they don't think a lot of classic FPS objective game types would work, aka play well, in Destiny. Game types like Capture the Flag, like Oddball. I honestly have to ask, what is the harm in trying? Wasn't that supposed to be the entire point of Crucible Labs, to try out new stuff? I think that possibly adding some new exciting game types could give the PvP community a shot in the arm if done properly. And right now, we kinda need some more variety. The Destiny content vault has swallowed up Supremacy, Countdown, Lockdown, Breakthrough, Doubles, Momentum Control, and Scorched. Back in August of 2020, Bungie mentioned that the original goal of doing this was to ensure that players weren't so divided between all of the options on the table, and thereby increasing the size of the matchmaking pools for the remaining playlists. That's fair, and I appreciate what they're going for, but at the same time, the current options seem a little stale. There has to be some kind of middle ground where maybe we can get some new and exciting variety without completely overwhelming the player base with an absurd amount of game types to pick from, and thereby shrinking up the matchmaking pool for current game types. The good news, at least in my opinion anyway, is that weapon-wise, I actually kinda like where D2 is right now. Yeah, throw a brick at me. I was very annoyed by auto rifles like Gnawing Hunger absolutely dominating the landscape back in mid to late 2020. I know people were salty about 150 RPM hand cannons getting taken away, but I like that 140s and even 120s are viable options in PvP right now. Revoker and Mountaintop have both died a horrible death, and I cannot tell you how happy I am about that. Feel free to disagree, but at the very least, weapon-wise, I like where D2 is right now, which isn't something I could say before. I'm sure there is plenty more we could talk about, but as far as I'm concerned, these are the most common talking points I hear from the PvP player base at large. I do think that the experience can continue to improve in 2021, and I'm sure that knowing Bungie, we will probably hear about long-term game plans at some point. In the meantime, if you have any thoughts about the current state of PvP, I would like to hear from you. What exactly is keeping you from routinely stepping into Crucible? What frustrates you or your team? Is it sandbox related? Lack of rewards or incentive? Other, tell me, and also tell Bungie in a way that doesn't make you look like a lunatic. Remember, it's a touchy subject, but they do want to hear all of our critiques. They just don't want to be told to off themselves. Legit, don't do that. It's effed up. If you got anything out of today's video at all, please do me a favor and click the like button. Hopefully we can keep a dialogue going that in any way could positively contribute to the player experience overall in 2021. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. We'll be right back.